Greetings to all of you. This is Christie here again. Today's topic is belief system. Beliefs control results. You are made of your set of core beliefs. The difference between a successful and an unsuccessful person is not their results or outcome. It is their beliefs, because beliefs control results. Many times your beliefs may not be true. This is because we are influenced by our culture, by our environment, by our experiences. And today I want you to think about your beliefs, because many times your beliefs can become a prison system that can limit you. Today you have the choice to open up the door and come out, but for that you should know what's the right belief and what is the wrong belief. I will give an interesting example from a biological perspective to explain this. The world is incomprehensibly beautiful, with this gorgeous, lovely green plants, the wonderful and colorful birds, and the lovely creatures we see all around us. But how all this life came into existence, have you ever thought about it? Well, some biologists say that all this life came into existence from non-life. In 1953, Miller and Urey made an experiment, and they said that biologically significant molecules can be formed from a primordial soup. This is called primordial soup theory. But soon, biologists found a host of problems with this primordial soup theory, and it was overturned. Soon, another theory was brought into existence to explain how the first life came into existence. Panspermia theory said that the first life came to this world from space. Some asteroids brought the first life from space, but even this theory could not explain how the first life originated in space or elsewhere. Origin of life is a mystery. Sir Frederick Hoyle says the likelihood of forming life from non-life is 1 in 1 to a part, followed by 40,000 zeros after it. It's huge enough to bury Darwin and his theory with it. Coming to life from non-life, it's a great mystery how the first life originated. There are only two possibilities. Either it is supernatural creation, or it is spontaneous generation. Spontaneous generation is disproved. Spontaneous generation by chance is impossibility. But even then, many biologists are still holding on to that impossibility. Even when all truth points to supernatural creation, they do not want to leave their thought or belief, because they wanted to hold on to their deep-rooted belief system. Even we sometimes hold on to our false belief system, even though we know it is true. Today I encourage you to review your belief system, whether your thoughts, your belief, core set of beliefs is right or wrong. Many people are scared to dream big because of their limited beliefs. If you are struggling with limited beliefs today, tell that to shut up. Don't listen to that limitations within you. Many times people have wrong perceptions, limited perceptions about themselves, and they are scared to dream big. Today I encourage you to dream big. You are born to do something great. You are born to be a hero. You can change history. Don't allow your limited beliefs to change your future. Let not your belief affect your fate. Don't allow your past to control your present or your future. Allow the darkness of your past to go. Let the light shine forward. Don't allow others' opinions to change the reality. Don't listen to the wrong perceptions of others about you. Change your belief system from "I can do" to "I can do." You can do everything in the Lord who strengthens you. When the Lord is your strength, you are an overcomer.